Hello and welcome to all the viewers. So in this video we will going to discuss about lifting beam finite element analysis using ANSYS workbench. So if you see the schematic, it will represent the lifting beam, and here we will going to study the FEA for various scenario. The first scenario will be, like you can see that from here, the middle lifting hook we will try to lift, and at the bottom of this three lifting eye we will have a mass attached to this. So in this part we will see the middle one, and next part onwards we will see the cross one. Okay, so this slide represents the learning in this video. The very first we will discuss about the problem statement, that is lifting analysis, and then we will do our actual simulation work, that is like geometry cleanup for our geometry. Then we will see how to apply a point mass, and then we will discuss about how to perform the mesh as well as how to apply loading and boundary conditions. So once our solution deck is ready, then we will discuss about how to extract the results as well as how to see the animation plot for the deformation. Okay, there we will discuss about the stresses, like equivalent stresses. Also we will discuss about the total reaction. So this slide represents our actual problem statement. So if you see that here we need to perform a FEA, that is finite element analysis of lifting lug for a below loading and bounding condition. So basically this is nothing but our middle one is our lifting lug, or also called as a lifting eye, and the complete beam is nothing but our lifting beam, as it is used for a lifting scenario. So either you can call it as a FEA for lifting eye or FEA for a complete lifting lug. So here we need to follow some of the loading as well as boundary conditions, such as like the horizontal eye beam is loaded with 2 ton mass on each three section as shown in figure. So basically if you see that, this is nothing but horizontal eye section beam which is attached to these 2 ton masses. So basically we will going to replicate this with the help of point mass, that is 2 ton on each of the lifting eye. Okay, the next one is like assume beam is lifted along the fixed point as shown in figure. So basically this lifting beam is lifted with the help of hook, and then this mechanism is attached to the platform which is having 1 meter apart. Okay, so likewise we need to create a coordinate, and then we can apply the boundary condition with the help of remote basin. Okay, then also if needed we can simplify the geometry, and the material will be our structural steel. Okay, so these are the loading and boundary conditions. So for this we need to perform the FEA simulation. So now we are in our actual ANSYS window. So if you see that, this is nothing but our toolbox, and from here analysis system you just need to drag and drop your system. Okay, so I had already performed the simulation for the part 1, so you can see here like all green tick marks. Now we will going to repeat the same exercise in our another analysis system. So you just need to right click over here, and you will go through the edit geometry and design modeler. So before going to this, I just wanted to go, we'll take you on our website. So basically if you see here, this is nothing but our a blog, that is www.graphsinjury.com. So here you will find the various FEA related topics, like when we talk about FEA basics, you will find the basics topics, then advanced, then few FEA design suggestions. Similarly, you will find few of the blogs on a design, and also you will find the link for FEA tutorial as well as CAD tutorial. And the one of the important thing like FEA CAD geometry, if you go here, you will find that various our FEA CAD geometries which are attached to this links. So you just need to click on that, and here you can download the respective file. So similarly you will find that our present video geometry file also over here. Okay, so you just go through this and you will find the relevant topic, all the basic information, as well as like what is element type, what are the different types of elements. So likewise all FEA related information as well as design related information you will find in our let's go to our simulation. So once you will click on the design modeler, you will find that our geometry. So I had already performed some of the geometry editing operation. So in order to import the new geometry over here, you just need to go file and you can click here, import external geometry file. So once you will click on that, you just need to define your directory, and from there you can select your respective file. Okay, now there are different operations I just performed. Likewise, like I will show you from here. So I just removed this part, bottom part as well as top parts. So that will unnecessary will increase our mesh count as well as simulation time, because at present our area of interest is nothing but our horizontal beam as well as this middle lifting eye. Okay, and in addition to that, I further did some splitting over here. When you will find the hook which is attached to this lifting eye, there will be a line contact in actual, but you need to consider a few of the portion. In some of the analysis you will find that the whole this half portion will be considered, but you can consider this much part, that is it will give you the worst case results. So if you consider the whole part of this, then what will happen, your stress result will going to be distributed. So that's why I try to simulate the actual scenario. So at present we will going to discuss with how to do this simulation with the remote point boundary conditions. Okay, in next part we will see how to define contacts between the hook. So in that video I will show you how to include a lifting eye, or you can say the lifting hook, and how to define the contact, and then how to perform the simulation. Okay, now let's go to the another part. Once our geometry is ready, then you can perform the various operations. Like if you want to incorporate all this in single part as well as this in another part, and middle beam in single part, just to perform the hex mesh for I beam, you need to perform the various operations. Okay, so, but at present we will just consider all this in a single part, so that there is no need to define the contacts. So you just need to click on a form a new part. So if you see here at the bottom, you will find that shared topology method. If you keep this none, then it will not going to create imprints. If you keep automatic, it will going to create the attachment with each other. Okay, now let's go to our mechanical window. So you just need to double click yes. So once you will click on the model, it will take you into mechanical. Okay, so whatever the license you have, accordingly you just need to select, and you need to perform the pre-processing. Once pre-processing is done, then you can go with the another post-processing, and so is open in front of us. Now the next task is to see whether the parts are connected or not. So like if you see that these are in a single part, so just cross check. You can either do the mesh, or the simpler way is to see here by connection. So you can see that this will show you the connections. When there is a single, it will display with the help of red color, but right now at present we will see that all are in a green or black color. So that means that all are connected. Okay, let's keep that to body color. Now the very first thing, like we need to apply a point masses over here. So let's see, we will apply some of the point mask in Sur and apply a point mask. So just select the geometry. So go to geometry and select the bottom portion. So basically when you will find that inside this our geometry is attached, so here you can define the 2 ton of mass, and here you can put your respective vertical displacement. So at present we will just assume that it is 1000 mm. Okay, so you will find that it is somewhere here. Okay, now let's do the similar thing for the second one. Now let's see our, so like approximate distance you can consider just to replicate that point mass. Similarly, repeat for another phase, insert point mass, and here you can define 2 ton, and here you just define 1000. Similarly, repeat for the another point mass, and here 2 ton. Let's define the y coordinates. So I'm just shifting that for 23 mm apart from this. Okay, this is nothing but our assumption. So if you want to see the rescale, you just click on that and you will see the point masses. Okay, now here in deformable, so if you want to see some of the stresses also at this portion, so you can keep that deformable. Okay, now the next task is to see the contact. So as we know that these are in a single part, so there is no need to define any contact, and also ANSYS will also not going to generate any contact as all are in a single contact. So by default you will find the structural steel as a material. So for that you will find the various details like Young's modulus, Poisson's ratio, your bulk modulus. So we will only need a Young's modulus and Poisson's ratio as a material detail. Okay, by default it will going to take from the ANSYS library. If not, then you need to go to engineering data, and here you can define your material, and then you can accordingly you can select the respective material specifications. Okay, so you can also refer our another videos where we had explained about how to apply a different materials. Now the next task is how to perform the meshing. For that you just need to see the respective like it is 272 vertical height. So if you want to split few of the elements across this, you just keep sizing, and I will just go a faster way, like I will select all and I will apply, and I will define, let's see, roughly a 20 mm. Okay, so if you can even suppress this, and let's try with see the whatever the global mesh, based on the global mesh size it will going to perform the mesh. So if you want to see the correct mesh, then you have to split this in a different parts, like split this assembly in a single part, split I section B in another parts, similarly split bottom I sections in another parts, and then accordingly you can define the local mesh sizing from here, right? You can define the sizing as well as method like hex dominant or tetrahedron. Okay, but that will take a longer time, so that's why I am just giving. So if you see the global mesh is quite coarser, which is not useful, so that's why I had given this. And now let's clear and let's further do the mesh with the 20 mm size. Okay, so we just giving the global body sizing to all the components. Now if you click on the mesh, you will find some finer mesh compared to the previous one. Now here, as we know that here we will going to apply some of the remote points, so that's why it is better to keep this as fine as possible. So I will just click on apply, and I will put here 10 mm. Okay, let's see how it will going to perform the meshing with the size of 10 mm. Let's, you can even clear or you can even update the mesh. So now it is generating the respective mesh. Now if you see here, it will have some finer mesh compared to the previous one. And let's see here, insert face meshing. With the help of face meshing, you will find that it will going to create a proper right angle tetra. The mesh is very important when you are performing the lifting scenario, because Find mesh is only required when your area of interest. So basically, you just need to know that you should able to understand when I will going to do the lifting, where my highest stresses will going to develop. So at that point, you need to create the finer mesh. Okay, this mesh is also quite good, but what I will do, I will further define this lifting eye as a 10 mm size, so that, so here instead of method, let's delete this, insert sizing, define, and here you can define 10 mm. So here if you see that face meshing, it's showing symbol, so it means that there is some problem, or you can say that mesh is not, the face is not properly mapped, so that's why it is showing this kind of symbol. But you should not worry about that. Whenever it is possible to do a right angle triad at that portion, it will going to create the mesh. Whenever it is not possible, in that case it will ignore. Okay, now we can see that here. Now what I will do, I will further reduce this size 8 mm, and I will try to generate the mesh furthermore. So likewise, you just need to see where my higher stresses will going to be developed, and there you can define either a local size mesh like this, or you can even define the global fine mesh. Okay, so I think this is quite okay right now, and with this we will try to do our next task. So the next task is to apply the remote boundary condition. So for that, you just need to first generate the remote point. So as we know that our remote point is 1000 mm apart. So for that, let's first create the insert coordinate system. So, and now you just need to shift this Y. So go to coordinate, here you can offset Y, and here you can define 1000 mm. Okay. So likewise, you can create this coordinate. So I had already created that. So based on your, you will find that some sort of mismatch. Basically, this is due to your face selection. So from here we consider that, and this point is from this middle one. Okay, now if you see here, let's consider furthermore, apply. Now it is creating at this point, and from there you will find that we will going to shift that at a 1000 mm. Okay, now both coordinates are matching, so I will delete this. So likewise, you just need to create a coordinate at the center, and then shift this upward. Okay. Now the next task is to create the remote boundary condition. So for that, create a remote point. So right click here. I think the remote point is insert element orientation, insert surface, and right click on a model, and you will find the remote point. Now here it is asking us to create a remote point at the, so we will just select this respective coordinate. So along this coordinate we will going to create the remote point. So what I will do now, I will select this three faces. This is a very important point, like where you want to create a remote point. You want to select the whole face, or you want to select the only middle one. So basically, when you have a hook and which will going to lift this lifting eye and the complete lifting bill, you will find this, there is only a line contact. So in order to avoid the high stress, you just create some of the extra surface, and accordingly you can select the surface. Okay, this is very important thing. And here you need to see like whether you want to create a rigid or you want to create a deformable. So when you say the deformable, it means that this face will going to deform. When you say the rigid, it means that it will not going to deform whatever the loads are present. Okay. Now the next task is to see where the remote point is created. So now if you see, the remote point is created somewhere here. What we can do here, we can define 0, 0, 0. So now we can see that this remote point is shifted at the coordinate system. Now the next task is to apply remote displacement. So on this remote point, just select that remote point, and here what we can do now, we can apply all the coordinates with 0 degrees. So basically what we are doing, we are fixing this point which will not going to allow any movement, or you can say all 6 degrees of freedom we are keeping 0. If you want to put some rotation, like if you want to move this like this, you can define either 5-10 kind of thing. So based on your lifting scenario, you need to define this boundary conditions. Okay, now the next task is to apply standard earth gravity. So basically we need to apply standard earth gravity in negative y. Okay, so now our everything is ready. Now we just need to perform the simulation. So let's try to solve the simulation. Okay, so what we did here, we just applied the point masses. Okay, and then we created a remote point with the help of local coordinates, and then we applied the remote boundary conditions, and we applied, in addition to that, we applied the standard earth gravity. Okay, so now if you see, our simulation is performed. Now the next task is to extract the stresses. So let's first extract the total deformation, and then let's extract the stresses. Okay, now evaluate the results, and before that you just need to see whatever the reactions, force reactions we can see, and here we can apply on a remote displacement, and let's see, evaluate the, so here the total 61,283. Okay, now if you see here the properties, you will have 66 ton nearly, approximately. Now we will do one thing, either you can change the unit, let's convert that into US customary, and the total mass is like 13,777, and if you see the reaction also like 13,777. So basically whatever the applied loads are there, in addition to that, this point mass one, we will get the same reaction. It means that there is no problem with the FEA. Okay, so you can even cross check in the Newton. You just apply that by 9.81, divide by 9.81, so you will get the same weight what we have over here. Okay, in the properties, now our reaction validation is performed. The next task is to see the deformation. So in order to see the deformation, you can see the here already upscaled plots are there. Now no wireframe, or if you want some wireframe, you can display that wireframe, and you can even see that these are the red points are nothing but the constant equations. Okay, so this can be built with the help of remote displacement, and if you click on the solution information, here the option called visible on a result. So if you keep this as yes, then you can see that in a results. Okay, now the maximum deformation we can see is at the two ends, 1.55, or we can say the 1.56, and if you animate that, you can see that how it is behaving with respect to the vertical axis. So at present it is behaving that this point is fixed and we have applied the mass. Okay, and we will see the stress value for this respect to animation. So let's stop this now. From here let's pause that, and now the next thing is that let's put display furthermore to the true scale, or you can even unconfirm, no wireframe, and the maximum stress is 230 approximately. If you put some here a limit called 150, and here if you define 10, so you can easily cross check this. So this is mainly localized stress, and other than that we can see these might be the stresses which we will be getting. So the 120, or here somewhere it is 123, okay, 126. So these are the high stress value, and here also you can see in the range of 100, furthermore here 94. So likewise we are getting the high stresses like in the range of 130 to 100, or you can say from 90 to 130. Okay. Now, the question is that whether this one is will be the realistic scenario. Okay. For the middle one, lifting or lifting. The answer here is like, this is nothing but the worst case scenario. In order to perform the actual scenario, in that case, you need to model actual lifting hook. In that case, you can see, let's put this no. So when you define here the actual lifting hook and you can create a contact, that is what your actual scenario. In that case, you will get some sort of better stress results. Okay. Now, if you see the deformation also, from deformation point of view, you can see this whole part is not deforming because of our remote boundary conditions. So you just need to shift this and then you can see the actual stress over here. Okay. So that is what how you need to interpret the stresses. In next part, what we can do, we will try to model the actual lifting hook and we will see what will be the replication on a stress value deformations. Okay. Right. This is also the quick, or you can say the faster way to perform the lifting beam analysis. Okay. So that's it from our present video. And if you have any comments or any questions, I'm there to answer you. You can put the comments or your observations on the comment video, or you can say the comment window. I will going to reply as soon as I will receive the comment. So thank you guys. Bye bye. Take care.